let me know.
I believe we are ready for a countdown. Yeah, whenever you're ready.
All right, so let's go. 3, 2, 1, go.
Somewhere in Asia.
Okay. So I'm Flashy. All I have with me Finger Quick.
Hi.
This is Jet Set Radio. So we're gonna start off by doing this like tutorial thing. It's kinda boring, but we have to get through it so we can get to the good part of the run. So what I'm doing right now is I'm unlocking these two characters named Gum and Tab. Throughout the run, there are gonna be characters that wanna like join our team or whatever, but they're all like optional except for another two that we need to get. So in total, we're gonna be unlocking four characters, and we're gonna be saying no to everyone else who like shows up at our little window. And what I'm doing right now is I am like collecting spray cans and I'm spraying graffiti. Messed up a little bit there, it's fine. Okay, so that's Gum. Now we're gonna unlock Tab. And then with the blue pajamas. So what I just did right there is called spray canceling. I kinda got a glitch where the spray noise continues after I'm done. It should go away soon though. But yeah, spray canceling is where I enter the spray and I leave. Like, I spam the spray button and the exit the spray button at the same time, and it lets me, like, do it a lot quicker than if I were to do it normally. Because if I were to do it normally... Oh, I tripped. Okay. If I were to do it normally, I would have to do all these, like, kinda complex, like, control stick movements to spray. But with this way that we do it, we can just either spam up or down, depending on the character, and then the spray button. And we can spray really fast. So, there's like a 2-second time save called Bus Hop here, but I'm not gonna do it because it's not super consistent and I don't like it. I'm gonna lose 2 seconds.
And if you fail it, like, you have to go all the way back to the beginning, so if it saves like 2 seconds, but if you miss it, it wastes like 5 or 10 seconds.
Yeah. So now we're gonna start the first level, which is called Shibuya GG, and it's pretty fast. I'm gonna be picking Beat. We choose either Beat or Tab for the speedrun. For most of the levels, we're gonna be picking another character in the second chapter, but we'll talk about that later. The reason we pick Beat or Tab is because Beat holds 20 cans and Tab holds 30. So depending on the route, depending on how many cans we need at a certain time, we'll decide whether we need Beat or Tab. For this level, we're going to be using Beat. And a lot of runners, well not a lot, some runners just like to play as a certain character that they prefer depending on their spray direction that they use. So it's kind of like personal preference, but if you choose Beat and Tab, like if you switch between them, you can save like a couple frames in the character select screen over the whole run. There's a chance my game might crash at the end of this level, so let's hope that doesn't happen. It did not crash. That's very good. And that was the first level. So that was pretty short. The next level is a little longer and a little more. Like, it's got some more stuff. I'm gonna be picking Tab because he holds more cans. And I need 30 cans for this level. Alright, so we're gonna start off by like picking up these cans and walking up this like flight of stairs. It's kind of annoying having to do this because it's a little boring, but it's not too long. So this is a kind of tricky jump right here where I pick up this can. It's not too bad. And here's the first large spray. Pick up some more cans. Oh, okay. I didn't want to go up that elephant slide thing right there, but it's not too bad. Didn't lose me that much time, maybe like a second. Might have messed me up ever so slightly though, because I might get like a little 2 second cutscene. Actually, no, I won't. Never mind. Well, maybe. Okay, yeah. I messed up, so now I'm gonna get the cutscene. This like elephant slide thing's a little annoying. Okay, so that's like the cutscene right there where I escape and the guy like gets mad at himself or whatever. You could avoid that if you have like good movement and you don't let the cops get too close to you. So there's a chance the game might crash soon too. I usually don't get this crash though, so it probably won't happen, but let's hope it doesn't. Alright, the game didn't crash, so we should be good for the rest of the run on crashes.
Isn't there like one more place that it could crash?
I think there's one more, but I've never gotten the crash there, so I don't think it'll happen. I hope it won't happen. I think it's at the end of Grind Square where you can crash.
Yeah, that was a lot more rare to happen than at the end of like Love Trap or Shibuya.
Yeah. And I'm pretty sure it depends on your PC, because a lot of runners, like, runners crash more often than others. Like, I don't get crashes super often. And I'm pretty sure on console this game, like, never crashes. At least when I played it on console, it didn't crash for me. But doing, like, the spray canceling is a lot harder on console to get them, like, pretty fast. Because on PC, we use Joyta key to rebind the spray key from trigger to X or Y, one of the two. Because it's a lot better to press a button than like these triggers. But it doesn't have to be a button either. I know world record holder Fela uses like the bumper. The bumpers on my controller are kind of shitty, so I don't do that. That was one of my favorite levels right there that we just completed. It has the best song in the game, in my opinion. And it's like nice and like circular and fast. So that's one of the guys at the window that's gonna like challenge us to like have them join or something. They want to join us, and we would have to go and like, I don't know, do some stuff with them, but we just skip that. Or like, they're like optional, so like, hey, you want to go do this thing? And we're like, no, we don't want to do this thing with you. And then they just go away until like the next level where we have to say no again. It's a little annoying, but I have the muscle memory for it, I guess. I've like never like accidentally like gone into one of the challenges or anything like that. That's a kind of hard thing I just did right there, where I like picked up the can and like turned in the air to get those sprays. That's like a kinda new strat, even though it's like really old. That strat's actually probably like a year old now, but we used to do this thing where we like hit one of the poison jam guys on top. That's what this like fish gang people are called. They're called poison jam. And we would hit them and pick up cans from them, because each one of the like gang member people drop cans when you run into them. And we like work that into the route and stuff. It's kind of tricky when you have a route that involves running into them, because if you mess up, they could just like run away and not drop any cans, like if you don't run into them properly and stuff like that.
I still love how like in the Game Boy version of this, they call poison Slim Jam Monster Jam.
I didn't even know that.
I laughed the first time I saw that. Like, I love how they call the Monster Jam.
Yeah, I love Monster Jam. Alright, so this is the first boss battle in this game. Boss fights are like probably the worst part of this game because they're kind of hard, especially in the speedrun. So in a boss fight, every character that we need to kill or like take down has 10 HP, and you take 1 HP away every time you spray them with a can. So what I do, or what everyone does, is we collect 30 cans before we like trigger them, like, or not trigger them, but like, well, yeah, we have to go around and pick up cans depending on the route before we even like mess around with them. Right there, I just jumped over where they spawn, and that's gonna trigger them to come up here. So now that I have 30 cans, I can just wait for them to run into me, and hopefully if I spam well enough, they die. Alright, that was really fast, so that's good. If I mess up on the spam and they get like too far away from me, it could get really bad and I can lose a lot of time.
There's nice like... thing of, like, you all can right. continue.
Alright, so there's like 3 fights in the game, so hopefully we get good luck on all 3 of those.
What I was gonna say was, when you're doing one of those boss fights and you're behind the person and you're like spamming either like trigger or a button to spray them, if you're not within the distance to spray them, it actually won't waste a can. It'll only spray if you're within the distance of spraying, so there's no possible way to waste any cans when you're doing the boss fights.
Yeah, that's something nice about this game. In the sequel, Jet Set Radio Future, you can actually spray even when you're not prompted to, so you could like accidentally waste cans, and that could be pretty bad. But we're not playing that game right now, we're playing this game. I just messed up a jump. I don't know, that lost me maybe like 3 seconds. Not too bad. Oh, hello? Maybe, alright, 5 seconds. It's all good. So now here comes like a really, really dumb jump that if I mess up I'll have to... Okay, I didn't mess it up. If I would mess up that jump right there that I did where I picked up the blue can between those 2 roofs, I'd have to like walk all the way across level and then like grind up where I grinded up at the beginning and like do some dumb stuff to get back up here where I need to be, and it's really slow. But luckily I didn't mess it up, so we're living boys. Now we have this weird little transition hallway where we like walk 3 steps and suddenly we're at the top of the map. Don't even know how that works to this day, but...
I think I remember Anise was saying that like when your turn... a very small jump cut that I think is supposed to imply you going up to the top. But it's weird.
And also if you notice there's like this lady that like talks like through this like speaker thing when you walk in there. Like this little dialogue. Yeah, I used to think it was part of the song. Maybe it is part of the song. I think it's when you walk in there. Maybe I just walk in there at the same time every time I go in. Alright, so I got lucky and I picked Tab for this level because I'm better with Tab. Usually you just pick Beat. But when I'm in the character select, I just spam the direction of Tab and A, and if I get lucky, I'll pick Tab. If I get unlucky, I'll pick Beat, but it's not a big deal. But I picked Tab, so this could go a little faster than if I picked Beat. The reason why I play better with Tab is because with Beat, I like spam one like I spam down faster than I spam X. For some reason, so it like kind of messes up my spraying, but when I play with Tab that doesn't happen as often and I can do it a little faster. That's why I prefer playing as Tab. So now they're gonna send in some tanks to like kill us. Oh, I was gonna do this zigzag strat here, but I forgot to slow down in the air, so we might not get it. Alright, yeah. I despawned the tanks though, so that's nice. There's a chance that you could, like, despawn the tanks. Or, like, make them invisible or something, because, like, you still get shot at. But you don't, like, run into the physical tanks, so it's nice. Alright. That was pretty alright. That was pretty good. Now we're gonna do another boss fight, which in my opinion is the hardest one, because there's a chance that if you get too close to one of these guys on the first rail, he'll like knock you backwards and you'll lose like hours, literal hours down the drain.
Yeah, this is easily probably the worst boss fight in the game.
So for most boss fights, we kind of like we go around and get cans. For this one, we just like trigger them first, and then we have to kind of get to our setup like area fast before they get to it. I'm only gonna pick up 5 cans here because there's a chance I might get can glitch. I don't even know what can glitch is. I just know you like end up with more cans. That's good. Alright, so I got to that guy, which is good. I kind of missed some cans, which isn't great, but it's not bad. And now I'm gonna try to pick up these cans without messing up too bad, which is... Alright, that went pretty well. Now I'm gonna try to get this guy without him giving me too much trouble. Alright, that was alright. Not too bad at all. It could have been faster, but I'll take that, because it could have been way slower.
Yeah, that was a pretty decent tank fight.
And now we have the Loaf Shockers fight, which is the easiest one in my opinion, but it's kinda hard for other people. So, I'm gonna pick Gum for swag. Hopefully I don't mess this up, because I've actually never done this with Gum, but I've seen the world record holder Fela do it with Gum. So I'm gonna do it with Gum. Let's see how this goes.
The start of this fight is kind of tricky because you have to like trigger all three, but like at slightly different times, and then like trail down and try to chase after like one of them.
Yeah. So I got pretty decent first one, except I bumped into her, so that lost me some time, and I got can glitch, which was good, but it didn't really help me out because of that bump that I got. So that was a pretty good fight. Could have been like a few seconds faster. That was good. Let's get scratching. Bumping into enemies is really bad in this game because they just send you in like awful directions, like, and like they give you so much distance like backwards and stuff. It's pretty bad. Alright, so these are the two characters I was talking about earlier that are mandatory to unlock. This one's Cube. We're gonna unlock her first. We have to do this jump called Cube Jump, which is like hard. Is this Cube Jump? I think this is Cube Jump. I don't know what any of the strats are called.
I think Cube Jump is just the jump across those streets.
Yeah, okay. So this is Cube Jump. Let's see if I get it. Alright, I got it. I play with Japanese voices, so... she's gonna like do some weird noise, but usually she says, "I got mad skills," right there. It's pretty nice. I love her mad skills, not gonna lie. Now we're gonna race my man Combo, except we're not gonna race Combo, we're gonna be playing as Combo, and we're gonna race Beat. So, now we just wait for this. 3, 2, 1. I'm gonna try my best not to bump into Beat, because, like I said before, if you bump into an AI, they send you flying. So I didn't bump into him, which is nice.
Nah. I think it's kind of alright if you knock into him at first, because you still have to wait for the cycle for that one bus.
Yeah. So it's not too bad here. So yeah, here comes this bus, and I'm gonna try to skitch on it, which I barely got, but I did get, so that's fast. And this is gonna put us pretty far ahead of Beat. Alright, so I tried to get a grind trick jump off that rail, but I didn't get it, so that's fine. And now Beat is like pretty far behind us, and it's very unlikely that we'll lose this race unless we make like a huge mistake. But coming up is like this gate that we have to jump through, which is actually like super hard to jump through if you're like just starting off running this game or like playing it casually. Like that right there gave me so much trouble when I was like a kid. Like, it was pretty awful.
Yeah, half pipe physics are kind of annoying in this game if you're not used to them.
Yeah. So that's the Beat combo race, and now we're coming up to two levels that, fun fact, aren't in the Japanese version of this game. And if the Japanese version had skippable cutscenes, it would be faster because of that. But it doesn't have skippable cutscenes, so you just play on the PC version. And I don't think anyone owns the Japanese version in the speedrunning community other than me. And you need like a boot disk for it to work on like an American Dreamcast, and it's complicated. So these are the two like American levels that Sega made to cater to the American audience or some bullshit like that.
Wait, so did Megatherium, the Dreamcast guy, did he do his run on an American version?
I'm pretty sure he did. I watched it on like SDA like a long time ago.
I'm actually kind of curious how fast a Japanese Dreamcast run would be now. Cause wasn't his like a little over an hour?
I don't remember.
I'm kind of curious about them.
Now we're using the waifu cube right here to do this level. This is my favorite level in the game. I don't know, I just think it's cool. We have these like kind of hard-ish wall ride section where we have to pick up blue cans. I don't think I ever explained, but like blue cans are worth 5 cans and yellow cans are worth 1. And can management is pretty annoying in this game. You gotta be really almost perfect with the cans you collect. In Jet Set Radio Future, it's nowhere near as strict with the can management, and cans are a lot more abundant.
In this game, you can actually, if you have like a full set of cans, like how much can Cube carry? 25?
I think so.
Okay, so if you have a full set of 25 cans and you pick up another can, like it'll add it towards your thing, but it won't make you up to 26.
Yeah, you could like accidentally pick up cans and they won't add towards your can count. So I got like, earlier I got like a cutscene skip by accident. There's a way to get the cutscene skip like consistently, but I messed it up, but I still somehow got it, which is pretty neat. It's like one of those like 2 second cutscenes where the cops are mad. Like, they're mad at you for, like, escaping. Oh, hello? Can I spray? Alright, that spray took a lot longer than it should have, and I got whipped by this guy with his, like, golden whip. This game has a lot of weird enemies, especially the Golden Rhinos, which are what these, like, special police force people are called. They have, like, golden whips and, like, jetpack guys with, like, machine guns and, like, stuff like that.
The Afro Snipers?
Yeah, the Afro Snipers. I hate the Afro Snipers so much. I've lost many a run to Afro Snipers. Me and Harvest named the Afro Snipers. Oh god, I picked combo. It was awful. Okay, so I accidentally picked my main man combo. It's not a big deal because I can still do this level with combo, but he's just like awful to control. In my opinion, it's probably not true. They probably all control the same, but combo just feels like bad to control. Like he's so huge. And I think Anise said he controls worse, and I believe anything Anise says. Oh, okay. So
you
I
just don't play combo because he's black, right?
Nah, dude. I don't play combo because he's fucking, I don't know. You really set me up in a weird position here, Finger Quick. I don't like the noise this combo makes either. It's like weird. He's like, wah, wah, wah. He says yeah sometimes. I like combo better than JSR. Oh god, I missed the spray. Awful. Okay, let's see if I can save this. Okay, I saved it.
Nice.
So now there's this like shocky guy who's like shocking this rail. Oh god, stop.
Oh, I'm not gonna make this. Oh, why?
Actually, maybe. Maybe I'll make this. Oh, I made it! What the fuck? Okay. That was really something. This is really a good level right here.
What the fuck? That was such a bizarre angle you got there. How the hell did you get that?
Combo's hitbox is bigger, dude. Oh my god, that's so bad! No. Okay, so I just got hit off before I finished the graffiti by like the helicopter. Oh, that's awful. But it's not too awful.
Oof.
It's not like I'm gonna go overestimate. That would be really bad. I assure you I won't go overestimate. That's a promise. Alright, so I was too slow and I didn't fall down with my invincibility frames. Alright, that was kind of a little tiny train wreck. But we got through it. We got through it. It's all good. Alright. So now this is like a weird like thing that they did at the end of the game where they just combine like the first few levels of the game into like one big level and you kind of have to like backtrack through it. At least the route that we do, we backtrack through it a little bit, somewhat. And we play as Beat, because Beat's a nice Caucasian boy. I wonder if Beat's hair color is natural. I forget who said it, but like I think someone like said that like when they first played Jet Set Radio, they thought Beat had cucumbers on his eyes.
Nice.
I don't remember where I read that. I think it might have been like a YouTube comment or something. Like someone said that they thought Beat had like cucumbers on his eyes. Like there's like a relaxation, like spa cucumbers.
Like I'm trying to imagine his eyes, because it's been a while since I've seen his eyes.
It's like the... In this game, they're green. Like, his glasses.
Oh.
Like, they thought the green glasses were cucumbers. So, in that last stage, there were these, like, bombs that I could have avoided getting hit by, but I still got hit by two of them, because I'm awful at this game. But I'm not too bad.
Worst part is if you land on top of one of the cars and it carries you out of the level.
Oh yeah, that's a real bad thing that hopefully doesn't happen. That almost happened in my Kuso Fest run. But luckily it didn't. About how much longer does the run take? Well, my PB is like a 41. So...
He still has another hour to go.
Yeah. I went to scratch my nose and I got a suboptimal turn in the air right there. I got good at RNG though. I don't know if it's RNG, but I like to think it's RNG. Sometimes like the cops spawn and fuck you up. Oh god, okay. I missed the spray there. That's not great. But we'll manage.
I think they always spawn in the same area. I just think that the way they move is Wait, which cops are you talking about? Are you talking about the ones with like the bombs strapped to their chest?
Sometimes they just don't show up.
Actually, it might be. I don't know. I don't know if it's RNG. I feel like...
I think it has something to do with how many sprays you get before the cutscene starts.
Maybe. I don't know.
Okay, so I'm supposed to get on this car, but I'm bad, so I didn't get on the car. But we did it.
Oh, by the way, nice graffiti soul you collected there. Jet Set Radio is my favorite collectathon.
Yeah, I love collectathon games like Jet Set Radio. It's my little Jet Set Radio token, I like to call it. That's Piranha, my favorite character. We can't unlock her in any percentile. It's a shame. Alright, so this is my least favorite level in the whole game. Except for like all the boss fights. Solely because of this one instance where there's an Afro sniper right at the beginning and he kills my runs like every single time without fail. So, let's see if he decides to shoot me off or not this run. So there he is right there, you can see him in the bottom corner. Oh, what's he gonna do? Okay, he didn't fucking shoot me. Thank God.
There, if you do get shot off by the sniper, there is a backup, but the optimal way is to just not get shot, because it wastes a lot of time. Well, not a lot of time, but it wastes probably, like, seconds, which I guess is kind of a lot of time for this game.
Yeah. And in this game, like, small time losses feel so much bigger than they actually are. I don't know why, it just feels that way. Kinda cause, like, the movement is, like, kinda slow. So that Afro Sniper almost ruined everything I ever loved, but he didn't. So I'm gonna let it slide.
That was really close.
There's, like, a pretty quick backup that I could do there. Like, to get back on top of the roof, but it's still annoying. So I'm gonna get my young boy Enrique over here, this golden rhino statue. I don't think that's his name, but I'm gonna call him Enrique. Because I usually forget about that guy, at least I used to when I first started running this game. From now on, he's Enrique. A little fun fact about me in this little section. I never learned the route here, so I just assume that I'm doing it correctly. Alright, I missed that spray. That's not good. I think this is the right way you're supposed to do this route, but I'm not sure, so... like this little sewer area route.
Yeah, this is the way I've always done it. I think I've seen Maxi do it differently. Actually, have I?
It might have been me, because I always do something different when I go here. I always do some dumb stuff.
I just think doing the two big graffiti last for that first section, because like when you skate up the stair.
Yeah, I always used to do those last, I think.
Oh, you used to do it last? Okay.
OBS might kick off stream in 7 minutes. That's fantastic. Let's hope it doesn't do that. There's a little half-pipe strat. We used to go up those stairs until, like, I think Fela realized that you don't have to, or maybe Maxi, I don't know. Shout out to the JSR community, by the way. Alright, I'm gonna try hard strat here that Mogo found. Shout out to Mogo. Oh, I almost fucking got it. Alright, I'm gonna try it again. Alright, I didn't get it. I'm not gonna try this anymore. You could like jump on top of that statue. Oh god, I went the wrong way on the wall. So
I've never tried that strat. I have no idea how hard it is, but it looks really difficult.
I've done it in practice like a few times. It's not even that bad, but I'm just like nervous, I guess.
So... Oh, I don't feel like that statue has like a big hitbox on it to like stand on it.
It's not even like that tight when you get on top, like it's pretty lenient once you get on it. It's just kind of hard to coordinate getting the spray and getting on it at the same time.
Gotcha.
So we've got like 3 more levels left in the run. This is Ben 10 Burning, which is... There's like a new route, but I'm not gonna do it because I don't know it. And it only saves like 2 or 3 seconds. Maybe it saves more, I don't know. Just start off by coming over here and collecting a bunch of cans. If I could be good at this game for a second. Oh god, I have no speed. Gee willikers. Gee willikers, fellas. Okay, that's what that's supposed to look like. I'm supposed to have speed when I go into that. Did not have speed though. I'm gonna... Oh, okay. I was gonna get a cutscene there, but I didn't get one. That's nice. Real good. If I would have been a little faster there, I would have gotten that cutscene. Sometimes it's a little fast to be slow. So this is where you usually go off and do the fast route thing. It's kind of hard, but instead I'm gonna do the old route, which is where I come over here. Jump over these like big like karate guys, these huge ass guys. Oh no, okay, that's not what that strat looks like. That looks like this. Oh, okay, so I was gonna do a neat little stratty thingy. This guy kicked me through the wall, so I guess you guys aren't gonna see that today. Oh Christ, okay. That's not good. I said that as if it was like a really bad mess up, but it only lost me like 2 seconds. Maybe not 2 seconds. Maybe like 5 seconds. Ugh, okay. Not bad, not bad. Hello. Thank you. So now he's gonna, the pyro guy or whatever, he's gonna come with like his flamethrower and like do some crazy stuff. He doesn't really bother us at all with the route that we use. But if you're playing this game casually, he's a little spooky. Little spooky fella. There he is right there. You're gonna see him, he's like... So you just lit me on fire, it's not a big deal. We can take it. Tab's got that, like, flame retardant blue pajamas on. So now I'm gonna try something called Harvest Skip that I haven't gotten in, like, a few days, and it's really easy. Alright, I got it. That just skips, like, 10 seconds of skating or something. Oh, what the f- Oh, la 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 la. The train just hit me. That never happens. Okay. Okay, that actually wouldn't have happened, but I guess I pressed A on like an unlucky pixel, and I like started grinding on one of the train tracks, and it took me towards the train, and I got hit by the train. No biggie though, we're kind of doing this route backwards, but in the end it all works out. Hoo-ha, the whole world works. Now here comes the boss fight before the final boss fight. If any of you guys watched my Kuso Runs stream of this game, I fucked this up pretty badly. So let's hope I don't do that this time. Cause that would be pretty bad.
What'd you do when during the Kuso Run?
I let one of them get away from me and then he started skating around for like 2 minutes.
Yeah, that's annoying if that happens.
So, what I'm gonna do for this fight is I'm gonna pick up 30 cans while they skid around. Okay, that's not good. That's not good. That's not bad, though. It's not good, but it's not bad. Oh, okay, that's bad. Oh, god. So I gotta... Oh, no, this is awful. This is awful. This is terrible. This is the worst thing that's ever happened to me. Oh, god, they're coming. So I have to pick up these cans really slowly. So I can pick up the whole can pyramid. Yeah, they got past me. Jesus Christ. Not like this. I don't understand what's going on here. Oh god, this fucking jerk, dude. Oh, why? This could have been a PB run, but I just threw it down the drain right there, fellas. Oh my god, come here. Oh, I hate you. Alright, so I'd be done by now if I did this correctly, but I didn't do it correctly. And, so now I just need to fucking follow this guy. I hate this guy with a passion. Thank you. It wasn't as bad as my mess up in the Kuso Fest though, so. At least we got that going for us. Alright, so here's the final boss. It's kind of like easy, but it's really easy to mess up at the same time. So let's hope. Let's hope we get a good final boss. That'd be good. So this is kind of like a trippy kind of level. We're on top of this big like turntable. And there's gonna be this flying rhinoceros that shoots fire. We don't really encounter him because we spray so fast, he kind of doesn't bother us. So it's not a big deal. Then we got these like strippers and these like tubes with like rhino heads on. It's what I call T for teen, dude. Basically, we're just going around to these like support towers or whatever on the sides, knocking them down by spraying them. Some of them are simple grinds, and the other one, like the one I'm about to do, is like this like rotating thing. And you kind of just have to hope you get a good cycle, like this right here. This is a good cycle. Sometimes you have to wait for them to turn. We're just slow, but we're fast. I think I could just fall down here. Instead of having to do the cycle. It's a little slower, but I'd rather... Actually, I don't know if it's slower or faster. Whatever. It's all good. We're all here having a good time, having some fun. But I still have like 3 minutes in my estimate, so what I could do is just like mess around for 3 minutes, but I guess I'm gonna beat the game. So I gotta grind this and time. I kinda forgot to tell Skelly to be ready, but yeah, that's time.
Cool,
dude.
At about a 42:50, I think.
What a beauty.
Dust,
right along with the right. Well,
good run, Flashy.
Thanks, man. So I finally got this run in the marathon.
Yep.
Milk wouldn't let me do it, even though he had like 8 million people drop, but he finally did. God bless America.
Thanks for filling in for Wario World.
Yeah, no problem, dude. I love Wario. Wario would do the same for me.
Yeah.
Alright. God bless.
Alright, well, coming up next.